Welcome family, this is the Velvet Locks with another video for you today. Since my last video, I tell you, you guys have really came out. You really came out in full force with your love, with your support, with even stories to share regarding your own experience dealing with a narcissist. Because I know exactly what you went through or are going through, and it's not easy. One of my subscribers wrote me a letter. Meeting somebody, falling in love with somebody, opening your home and your family to somebody, only to then find out you made the biggest mistake in the world. I know in the beginning, the earlier part of my relationship with this person, I realized a very bad, low self-esteem. I realized this person had none at all. Very jealous of everybody, of everything. Constantly degrading people. I mean, he always had negative things to talk about, to mention about people. Even in the streets, as we were walking, driving, no matter what. Even of his own family and children. Which is one of the reasons why his children and me never really met or got along with each other. Because he always seemed to put a division in between both sides. He liked to play both sides against the fence. He would say one thing to one set of family and then another thing to another set of family, and then have both sides feeling a certain type of way towards each other. Then all of a sudden now wants to mend the family together, but all this time you played one side against the next. It was always confusion and craziness. He never had anything nice to say about his family. Never had anything nice to say about any of his kids. Never had anything nice to say about any of his ex-children's mothers. It was always the woman's fault. The first thing they want to do is blame. They want to shift the blame on how rotten this person was, how bad they were in the relationship, and what you had to do to get out of it. When in fact, it was all a lie. It was all a lie, playing on your emotions. I went on to believing all the lies that this person was telling me. I remember when we first started, one of his children, his oldest daughter, reached out to me on a DM on Facebook. And she really put it about his character. Now, at the time, I'm thinking to myself, well, his oldest reached out to me and told me exactly the type of person he was. At that time, I didn't believe her. I wanted to believe him because, you know, a lot of times when you get into these new relationships, there's always an opposition somewhere hoping or trying to destroy something. So you don't know whether or not to believe the person or to trust the person. Because, you know, I'm just coming into this not knowing anybody. I told him about what was said. Of course, he denied it. Of course, he acted like all was, you know, they're just looking for money. They're only trying to use him. But I believed him. I don't know why, but I believed him because, you know, you're trying to trust that person. But then another one popped up, an ex-wife. So this person popped out and told me so many different things about him. Please take note, not everybody is jealous of you in your relationship. Women will hear certain things. They will be in your situation not knowing nothing. And then finding out that the person that played games with them is now in a new relationship and you're the new relationship. So now they're trying to warn you of who this person is. This is what I got in the beginning of our relationship. Warnings. Not all times people are warning you are out to try to ruin you. They really could legitimately be warning you. And that was red flag number one. I had two people back to back warning me in the beginning of this relationship. But I didn't listen. I didn't go along with what they were saying. I wanted to give him the benefit of the doubt. So the warnings were coming. But I didn't see the warnings as warnings. Another red flag was he was constantly putting down all his ex relationships. Always putting down the women, always making them seem like they were the ones at fault. They were the ones that ended the relationship. It was always their infidelities and everything under the sun. But he never told on himself and what he did that caused anything. And what I found out later on was basically he was the cause of everything. I truly believe that these women were completely going through the same thing, and then he played the same games on them. So watch out when you're meeting somebody and you get these warnings. You get people calling you out of the blue, DMing you on Facebook or wherever to try to get to talk to you and to warn you on what kind of person this is. Sometimes it's good to listen and talk. Not everybody is out to get you in your relationship. They could be trying to open your eyes to what this person really is about because they've been through it. And that's something that I didn't look at and really take heed to or even pray about at the time. Another red flag was always accusing me of talking to other guys or allowing men to talk to me. One thing you gotta realize, fellas and ladies, is with narcissists, they are extremely jealous people. They have very low self-esteem. This one had none at all. And I don't mean low, I mean none. Zero, zilch, dip, zip, nothing. Everything that I liked, he liked. Anything I didn't like, he didn't like. He mirrored everything about me. And it seemed as though he was trying to be like me. To the point of even my own expressions, he started doing. And I would look at him and I'd be like, what? You know, yeah, I started noticing he was mirroring me. I have this thing, you know, me and my daughter, when we see something, we're like, oh, that's cutesy. Oh, that's cutesy. To the point where I heard him describing clothes when we go shopping as, oh, that's cutesy. This lady looked over at him and walked away. So I'm like, dude, that ain't cool. Dudes don't say cutesy. Don't let me hear you say that no more. Dudes don't say cutesy. But it was constant trying to be like me. Another red flag for you to also look out for, ladies and gentlemen, is when they compete with you. This competition thing going on. When you see this tit for tat, always trying to one-up you. Always trying to have something better than you. It wasn't until I started noticing a competition. Either he was trying to get my kids to not like me by loving on them, love bombing them so much to the point where, oh, everything was all about him. That's the first thing you gotta watch out for. Any person that comes in your home and wanna put a wedge in between you and your family, causing them to wanna be more with that person and not with you, that's a red flag right there. Trying to cause interference and disarray. Trying to cause separation in your family life. That's what he tried to do the second he got comfortable. And the second he got comfortable, that's when the real him started coming out. Now, one thing, ladies and gentlemen, you got to realize with narcissists, they wear multiple masks, okay? They put on a mask for anything. When they're trying to be on their best behavior, that's their mask. They're trying to get you to feel comfortable. They're trying to make you think that they're this wonderful person. But all of that is fake. It's all fake. It's an illusion. It's a mirage. They're only trying to get you to believe something that is not real. That is really not who they are. They don't have feelings to really show love. All of that loving and love bombing and wooing you, I fell for it and I really thought it was genuine. But the mental part that comes with that is when you realize it's all fake. As realistic as it felt, it's all fake. They don't really love you. It took me a long time to realize that. To really fathom that this is fake. That a person can actually talk about marriage, even want children. Listen, let me tell y'all something. One thing I realized with dealing with this person was he wanted to try to impregnate his victims as a way to hold them down, to have control in their life of some sort. Him trying to rush me in the beginning, love bomb me, talk about marriage all in the early stages of dating, talk about, oh, you're the most beautiful person, da da da, all of the lovely stuff to get into your heart. But all of that is their little tricks and snares of trying to get into your heart, trying to get into your life, because they see something about you that they want. They want to be like, they want to have, they're jealous of, they want to destroy you. It took me a while to realize that. In the meantime, he's painting this perfect picture and everything to his family while he's over here wrecking our family. They don't tell on themselves with their people. They just want their people to think that you're this rotten person. This person that is out of control. This person that is so mean-spirited. But really, in reality, it's them. It's them. They do a lot of mind manipulation. They do a lot of bullying. Okay? Growing up as a little boy, being dysfunctional, having behavioral problems in school, learning disabilities, whatever the case is. This is where it all came from, on top of other little things. But I ain't gonna get into that today. But a narcissist is sometimes raised by a narcissist. And that's what I realized afterwards. He was mimicking the same person that caused him to be this way. He was mimicking and mirroring the behaviors, the dysfunctions from that person in his family, and thought that that was how a man is supposed to behave. At the same time, he's wrecking lives, he's lying, he's stealing. I mean, this man has stole some stuff, y'all. Narcissists don't have feelings. They don't care. It's all about themselves. It's all about what they can get. I remember when he used to come by and he had all this money. I know for a fact he was stealing it. And he was stealing it from his own family. He was using the innocent minds of his elderly parents and taking their money, because they kept a lot of money in the house. I mean, when I met this person, he had nothing and was using his father's credit like crazy. Just ran through the credit, tore up the credit with no thought and care in the world. So you really can't trust them, because if they can do this to their own family, flesh and blood, who are you? One of the things that I realized was the major problem that I thought of at the time was the constant arguing. And that little thing turned into something as big as a doggone tsunami. It didn't matter where we were. It didn't matter whether in private or public. A narcissist always looks for attention. And it doesn't matter if it's bad attention, good attention. They want attention. They want people to see. If they're angry, they want to show that they're angry. They put a show on in the streets. This man used to always constantly act out in public, okay? Didn't care the fact that that's not who I am. I'm not about that public embarrassment, especially being a public figure now. This is not who I am. But they don't care. They don't care. They don't care about your feelings. They don't care about your hurt. They don't care who's watching. It's all about their anger, their madness, and they're pissed off. So boom. And with this narcissist, it was a never-ending thing, because it was a constant cycle of constantly talking about the same thing, constantly beating you in the head with the same crap, to the point where you get weak in your spirit. You're stressed out, you're weak, you're tired, you're frustrated, and you're dealing with somebody who is constantly attacking you verbally over dumb stuff. One thing with narcissists that you should really also understand is they like to feel as though they know what they're doing. And a lot of times, they don't know a damn thing about what they're doing. They don't even know where they're going. They don't have a doggone direction, a future. They don't have no focus. They want to be leaders but can't lead. They lead you right into financial debt, because that's the only leadership they have. Leading you into financial debt. They will suck the life out of you like a vampire. They will suck you dry financially. They will use your personal information for their own benefit, such as credit card, running up your credit. Always credit, 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 credit with this person. Everything was credit, credit, credit. I helped this man so much get his credit back good. And only for him to then turn around and blow it all off again on the next woman. Now, all this time I was with this person, never once have I had the thought that he was cheating. But it wasn't until after we broke up and after I moved on that even though I moved on, he was still hovering me. He was still calling me, harassing me a million times. It's stalking. When you're leaving a narcissist that is not willing for you to leave for whatever selfish reasons, because it's not about love. It's not because they love you that they don't want you to go. It's because they're losing their supply. It's stalking. Constant texts, constant coming through around the house to the point where it's stressful. It's stalking. You can't turn around without them being there. Stalking. They like to try to do everything in their power to break you down so you give them another chance. That's the cycle of dysfunction. And that's the hamster wheel that I was on with him. A cycle of dysfunction, and it would always go around in the same way. Our relationship didn't have much happy times more than bad times, because we would have maybe 2 weeks of good times and the rest of the month was hell. And this was a constant thing. And as positive as I am, it was a struggle. It got to the point now, your girl who was in excellent health, after dealing with that man, my pressure went up. I was having blood pressure issues. Yes. Yes. These people will cause your health to get so bad to the point where you could either get stressed out, stroked out, heart attack. You can die dealing with these people. And I'm not saying that to take lightly. It's straight up serious. You can die dealing with these people. Not even just physically, but you can mentally die. You can go into such deep depressions dealing with these people, with all the trickery and the mental manipulations that they do, trying to erase your reality. They are master deceivers, master manipulators, con artists, criminal minded. This person, after him going to therapy, he was getting worse. And during that time when he was going to therapy, we was really having some serious relationship problems. And I had put him out the house, and he ran back to his parents' house, which is where he usually goes to. Not only was he at his parents' house, but he was also with other women. Now, at that time, I didn't know about that. Although he never made me feel that way, and that's the thing. That's the trickery, y'all. That's the manipulation and the smokescreen. Because they got you so wound up thinking one thing. You're not thinking that they're even capable of doing these things to you. But they do. It is inevitable. They don't know how to be faithful. Because they're always moving from one person to the next person to the next person to the next person. It's a supply source. It's like body snatchers. It's like vampires. They gotta get their next feed. The same as narcissists. They're constantly looking for victims to manipulate, to trick, to rob, to steal. This man was trying to impregnate two other women while he was trying to be with me. He was telling them the same crap. I love you, you're my woman, you're my wife. You're my this, you're my world, you're my girl. Was even preying on a 23-year-old young lady, the same age as his youngest daughter. And he used her badly, badly. She was his financial supply. Constantly bailing him out of financial problems. Constantly taking him to hotels so that he can have a place to lay his head. Okay, used her in the process because he didn't want to go back to his mom and daddy's house. So this was a gigolo, a male whore. I mean, reckless behaviors, you guys. Reckless. They're not faithful. They don't know how to be faithful. They're never faithful. As much as they make you feel like they're not capable of cheating on you, they're cheating on you. Their self-esteem is so low. They have to feel good. They want people that's going to pat them on the back, stroke their egos, make them feel good. But they are not only man whores, but they're child-minded. Child-minded. Nothing in there at all. At all. Always acting like a kid. Always thinking like a kid. Doing stupid things. Another one, when they constantly blaming you for talking to other people, cheating with other people, just know that's because that's what they're doing. Blame shifting, wanting you to think that you are the cause of the problems in the relationship when they're out there sneaking and tricking around with females or men. They like to smoke screen you and thinking that, oh, they're this perfect being and you're this jacked up person. No. That's the breaking down of your spirit. They're constantly trying to break you down. Break your will. Break your power. Break your self-esteem. Because if you're a sound-minded person, it's harder to break your self-esteem. But a narcissist, they're so weak. They're so broken. They're so messed up in the head that all they want to do is cause you the same kind of pain that they're living in their reality. They have so much stored up guilt from the things and that they've done to so many people in the past that they're constantly running from their past, from their own demons. This is why they're angry. This is why they're frustrated. This is why they cannot think of anybody in a good light. They're looking at everybody in a negative manner because they're hateful. Although they're smiling and wooing you, they're also talking bad about you. They're also stabbing you in the back. They're also looking at other females or men. They're picking other people up. And this is what they're telling those people because they're looking for new supply. They're looking for new people that's going to come in and feed their ego, feed whatever it is that they're in need of. You're only temporary. And it's so true. They lose interest so fast in anything, even relationships. This is why they bounce from one to the next to the next to the next. Because once you start seeing their reality, once you start seeing them for who they are, and that their mask is starting to slip off their face, their reality is exposing. Once they start exposing their reality to you, you're being aware of who they are. You're starting to get alert signals. And you're starting to question things. They don't like that. They don't like that. They don't like to be found out. They don't like for you to see that there's something wrong. So they start trying to replace you. And that's what they do when they're seeking out other supply. They move fast. They don't even give them time to recuperate. So they still got all this built up hurt, animosity, frustrations, everything. And now they're in a new relationship. What I kept hearing about a narcissist, that they do cheat. And yes, He was living a lie. And it's sad. It's really sad that people go around doing these things to people and think that they can get away with it. And think that karma does not know the address. Karma knows exactly where he goes, where no matter what it is. So just know that when you are dealing with somebody like this and they cause you so much emotional, mental, financial harm, just know their karma is coming. It's inevitable. But what you reap is what you sow, okay? And I've seen his karma come into light, starting to be played out. But it ain't the end because of all the hurt that he's done so many people. It's gonna be devastating. The results for him is gonna be devastating. I know I've been on here for quite some time. I know I've been all over the place in this video. But just know that what you believe to be reality when you're living with this type of people or involved in a marriage, it's not a reality. It's a fake relationship. You may feel the reality of it, but they don't care. They don't know how to care. They don't have feelings like that. Although they show all sorts of crazy emotional feelings when they want to show you out, when they want to put on a show for you, when they want to get your attention, they could drop tears at the drop of a dime. This person used to try to act like he was so sick that he always would run to the hospital and call me talking about I'm in the hospital. Because I knew it was trickery, trying to get a rise out of you. And I realized this person's playing games with me. Because not only is he playing games by putting on a show and acting like he's sick. You're not sick. Listen, get off that hamster wheel. It's going to be hard, but you're going to have to get off that hamster wheel. And the first thing that I did was deaden every avenue of contact that he could possibly do. No phone calls, no texts, no third party contacts. That means I had to leave his family alone too. No communications with them even. Nothing. It's hard when you have a child with this family and you have to deal with them. Is this so many layers? So many layers to this. I have so much more exposed about a narcissist to make aware who these people are. A lot of times we don't know what's going on. We just know our world is turned upside down and we don't know how to fix it. There's so many things that I have to share with y'all. But for those of you who are just involved in just a regular relationship with them, even if you're living with them, you're gonna have to find yourselves because this is gonna drain you so much to the point where it could kill you and it could destroy who you are, where people don't even recognize you anymore. They don't see that lively spirit because it's been sucked out of you by that narcissist. He was like a demonic spirit that came in my home like a flood to destroy everything he could possibly destroy because that's how they feed. They like that negative attention. They like that argumentative spirit. They like that. So the less communications you have with the narcissist, better and the faster you're going to heal. But you should also go to counseling because of the damage that they leave behind in your spirit, in your mind. In order for you to live a healthy life for somebody else, you're going to have to work on your inner being, your spirit man, because they are only to destroy whomever they come in contact with. So you guys, I thank you for joining me on this video again. Continue to share your stories. Continue to talk to me. I'm here for you. So many people are on YouTube trying to expose and to open your eyes to these type of people. But it's not until you meet them that you really need to start looking into these videos now. Because like I said, I'm not an expert. But I'm an expert at what I've been through with that joker. I don't need a degree for that. I don't need to go to medical school for that. Okay? I don't have to be a doctor to see that for what it really is. And neither do you. Be safe, you guys. Be safe. Because I'm going to talk to you in the next video about how to stay away, how to stay no contact. And also, some of you may need to get restraining orders. Because that's what I had to do. Stay tuned for the next video. Welcome YouTube family, this is the velvetlox introducing to you my new channel, and this channel is called Velvet Vlogs. On this channel you will see hair videos, skincare videos, as well as family vlogs, okay? So check it out, go down below, click those links, and subscribe, as well as turn on your notification bell, and I will see you there.